Hey, what's going on, guys? I'm Reggie Bush, and as we get closer to the college football season, I want to give you guys a sneak peek at my top five running backs to watch. Let's get started. Number five, Eno Benjamin, Arizona State. I had to show the Pac-12 some love because the disrespect is kind of real right now. It's hard out here for us, but Eno had 300 attempts. That's a lot of carries for a running back, but he was still very productive with 16 touchdowns. When you turn on the film and you watch this kid, he has great lateral jump cut ability, which makes it very hard for defenders to tackle him in open field. He breaks a lot of tackles for a running back his size. He's only 5'10", 200 pounds, but he's very durable, very strong. I'm looking forward to watching this kid this year. I think if he has another 300 attempts, he will break the 2,000-yard rushing mark. But Eno, take it easy on my USC Trojans, please. Number four, J.K. Dobbins from The Ohio State University. His running style kind of reminds me a little bit of Zeke Elliott, ironically, but just another productive running back from Ohio State. They keep churning them out year in and year out. J.K. had back-to-back 1,000-yard seasons as a freshman and a sophomore. If he hits that 1,000-yard mark again, he will be in the same conversation as Archie Griffin, the only other Ohio State running back to accomplish this feat. And you know what? I think he'll do it. I fully expect him to be the workhorse of this offense and to help Ohio State get back to the playoffs. Number three, DeAndre Swift, Georgia. Had the least amount of touches of any of the running backs in my top five, 163 to be exact. I think if he has more touches, he could be the best college football running back right now. I think he's that special. His running style reminds me a little bit of Shady McCoy. He's shifty as hell, has the ability to stop and cut on a dime. He's very, very versatile. He can hurt you in a passing game, catching balls out of the backfield, which I love, I'm a huge fan of. But he struggled in the Sugar Bowl. He had two fumbles. I fully expect him to use that as motivation and to run angry this year. He is a big part of the reason why I think Georgia can get back to the college football playoffs. Number two, Travis Etienne from Clemson. Maybe the most productive running back out of all of my top five with respect to scoring touchdowns. Travis scored 24 touchdowns. That is ridiculous. That's a lot of production from one running back. He's more of a straight line guy, not as shifty as some of the other running backs in my top five, but still highly productive, breaks a lot of tackles, and I think he is the benefit of great talent around him. I think he takes advantage of that. And last but not least, number one, Jonathan Taylor from Wisconsin. He is the best running back in college football, period. My man had 8 200-yard rushing games. That is absolutely ridiculous. I love the way his linemen block for him. These big boys are aggressive. They're finishing blocks down the field. They're pulling up to three guys at a time, two tight ends and a tackle. That puts a lot of strain on the defense because if one defender misses his gap, misses his assignment, Jonathan Taylor is gone running down the field and nobody is catching him. He is the total package in my eyes. And I fully expect at the end of the season, he will be sitting in the chair at the Heisman ceremony.